Hello boys and girls of grade 6, I am Miss Martina Archer-Semple, and today our topic is mollusks. Yes, we will be looking at mollusks. So at the end of the lesson, you would be able to identify and describe mollusks' anatomy and to be familiar with the texture and shape of shells. Also, you're going to know their names of at least three features of commonly seen shells, such as cones, mounds, clams, mussel, top shells, frog shells, etc. All right, here we're having a picture. Can any of you tell me what are these things in the picture? Yes, they are mollusks. Okay, now before we get into the lesson, I have one simple question for you. Do you think the organism in the picture is a fish? Answer, shellfish is a colloquial and fisheries term for exoskeleton bearing aquatic invertebrates used as food, including various species of mollusks, crustaceans, introderms. Despite the name, shellfish are not actually fish, but are simply water-dwelling animals. Yes, so despite the name shellfish, are not actually a fish. Yes, you heard that correct. But they are simply water-dwelling animals. Okay, our second question. True or false? Mollusks are found only in oceans. Mollusks are found only in ocean. Is that true or false? Right, that is false, because mollusks occur in almost every habitat found on Earth. Yes, almost everywhere they can be found on Earth. Where they are often the most conspicuous organism, while most are found in the marine environment, extending from the intertidal to the deepest oceans, several major gastropods clads life predominantly in freshwater or terrestrial habitats. Okay, let's start our lesson today. Mollusks, the phylum mollusks, includes snails, slugs, clams, and squids. Mollusks are soft-bodied animals that typically have internal or external shell. Like annelids, mollusks have true clothlums surrounded by mesoderms. They also have complex organs Why are the animals as different looking as snails, clams, and squids in the same phylum? One answer lies in the behavior of their larvae or immature stages. Many molluscs have a free swimming larval stage called trochophore. Now, the trochophore is also characteristic in many annelids, indicating that annelids and molluscs are closely related. Yes, they are closely related. Although there is no single feature that all molluscs possesses, three features are more so common in molluscs than in other phyla. And if we look at that picture there of that snail or slug that we may call it, you may see what we're talking about. All right. Now, after you would have listened to the content that you would have gotten just now, let's try to understand three features in molluscs. One, a specialized foot used in digging, grasping, or creeping. Two, a mantle or mask of soft flesh that covers the soft body and encloses the internal organs. Thirdly, we have a radula, which in most species has a rasp-like scraping organ used in feeding. Yes, and these are the three features common in molluscs. Let's go it over again. The three features common in molluscs are: one, a specialized foot used in digging, grasping, or creeping. Two, a mantle or mass of soft flesh that covers the body and encloses the internal organs. Three, a radula, which in most species has a rasp-like scraping organ used in feeding. There are over 50,000 known species of molluscs, and that only makes them second to the arthropods in invertebrate phylum size. Yes, molluscs are typically divided into 10 classes, of which two are extinct. The major classes of living molluscs include gastropods, bivalves, and gastropods include snails and slugs. Bivalves include clams, oysters, and mussels. Cephalopods includes the octopus and the squid. Okay. First practice question. Gastropods use this to scrape food. Gastropods use this to scrape food. A, mantle. B, foot. C, radula. Again, gastropod use this to scrape food. A, mantle. B, foot. C, radula. Which part of the molluscs body is specialized for burrowing, feeding, and movement? Which part of the molluscs body is specialized for burrowing, feeding, and movement. A, the trophophores. B, the visceral mass. C, the mantle. D, the foot. Again, A, the trophophores. B, the visceral mass. C, the mantle. D, the foot. Again. Question number three. Which of the following is a function of the mantle in many molluscs? Which of the following is a function of the mantle in many molluscs? A. Mantle covers the internal organs, may also create shell. B. Mantle enables the molluscs to move. C. Mantle helps the molluscs digest food. Or D. Mantle removes waste. All right, question four. Which mollusk is thought to be very intelligent and why? Yes, which mollusk is thought to be very intelligent and why? And our final question for that part is, what is the defining feature of a bivalve? What is the defining feature of a bivalve? Or bivalve. Yes. Question one, the answer should have been radula. And if we would have looked and listened properly, number two, it is foot. Yes, question two, the answer is foot. Yes, question three, we ask, which of the following is a function of the mantle in many molluscs? And the answer is, a mantle covers the internal organs and may create a shell. Yes, that's a function of a mantle. All right, question four. Which mollusk is thought to be very intelligent and why? Yes, which mollusk is thought to be very intelligent and why? Cephalopods are thought to be the most intelligent of invertebrates. This is because they have eyes and other senses that rival those of humans. The cephalopods also have prominent head and a well-developed brain. Yes, and earlier we asked, what is the defining feature of a bivalve or bivalve? And that answer is, as their name implies, they have two parts of their shell, which can open and close. This is the defining feature. Okay, so in conclusion, after the arthropods, the mollusks are the most successful of all animals in terms of number species. All mollusks have a soft body, which is generally protected by an external calcium-containing shell. Yes, external calcium-containing shell. the shell of the snail, the oyster, clam, and mussel is located externally. They are found outside of their body. The shell of the squid is located internally. However, the octopuses and sea slugs do not have a shell. Yes, the octopuses and the sea slugs do not have a shell. All mollusks breed by gills, and they lay eggs. Yes, they all breed by gills and they lay eggs. The shells are their houses in which certain soft-bodied animals live. The shell protects them. Yes, the shell protects them. Each animal builds its own shell. These animals can be seen on land, in fresh water, and ocean. Depending on how an animal makes its shell, some may be smooth, whereas some may be rough. Some will have no design, others will have patterns. They also have different colors. The colors are also because of the way the animal secretes substances for making its shell, right? These soft-bodied animals have a foot that is muscular, meaning made up of muscles, no bones. How the foot comes out and how it is used is in locomotion, right? Yes, it is a locomotion. Okay, this would have brought us to the end of this session. I am Miss Martina Archer-Semple saying, stay safe, be good boys and girls, and do remember to do your research. Bye.